guys, welcome back to Slipping Out Episode 5 Part 2, where we're going to continue taking a look at the evil within. So near the beginning of Chapter 6, we come to this huge tower on the clifftops, and we can see here the map isn't fully loaded up until we go through the first set of gates. We can also see close up that the birds circling the tower are 2D, but of course normally we wouldn't be so close, and you can't really tell from such a far distance anyway, so it's not really a big issue. If we then take the camera around the back of the map, we can see the church that we eventually get to floating in the distance, and even further outside the back of the map, we can come to this small room, which looks like the room that we wake up inside throughout the game, located in the Safe Haven Asylum. Way over across the map, which you can barely see from our location in fact, is the 3D model of Beacon Hospital, which of course we took a look at in part 1. But just check out how far away this is from the section of map that we play in. To see where Joseph's head goes if we let it get cut off, then stay tuned for a future video where I'll be showing all the goriest parts from the game from the camera shots you won't have seen them before. So whilst taking on the two brothers, first of all is Zen. I wondered what Noon was doing, and as we fly the camera around, it turns out that he just stands there waiting for his brother to be defeated. Nice. There are a lot of things in The Evil Within which remind me of Resident Evil 4, which is probably why I like it so much, but one of the things is the bag that wriggles about, and in the Res 4 episode, I got a lot of requests from viewers asking to see what was inside the bag. Unfortunately, there wasn't anything inside, and it's not much different in this one. A bit disappointing, I know, but what we can do is see where all these body bags on this overhead chain conveyor are coming from and going to.
I think I smell those things. They might be nearby. Does it seem a little harder to move lately?
Check out the sentinel dog, guys. Like most of the creatures in the game, it is pretty messed up.
I don't know why, and I can't reason it away. It's deeper than that. It's like instinct.
During the cutscene inside the church, we get these very quick snaps of the brain, and I was curious to know if anything else was around it at the time. Well, it turns out the shot is inside the full church, with the brain and stem positioned just above the floor, presumably to get the right camera shot for the scene. The first time that we see a keeper during the game, he disappears behind this metal door at the bottom of this corridor, but is he still on the other side? Well, as we can see, it turns out he isn't, but if we go around the corner with the camera, we can find Leslie inside what appears to be a very poorly designed cage. One of the things at this point I wanted to find out was if there's anything above the ground through these large holes in the cave. As you might have guessed, no there isn't, but it does give us a chance to see how some of the awesome lighting effects are used within the game.
Mm-hmm.
Where do babies come from? It's a popular question, and it turns out they spawn in Chapter 8, just above your head. At the end of Chapter 8, there's an interesting part of the game, especially for you viewers who are into game design. If we fly the camera down the cave, which we can't normally get to the end of at this point, we can see the laboratory at the end. Now, what I like about this is the developers have created a map within a map. As you can see here, the hospital corridor is hidden behind the rocks of the cave. So when we seemingly move from one part of the map to another, it's not our character that moves, it is in fact this whole section of cave. So if we slow the game down, we can see this happening from the normal view. And after quite a few attempts at this, I managed to get this footage of it happening from outside. Just after this, Amalgam Alpha chases us through the corridors of the asylum, but where does it come from in the first place? It's actually hiding underneath the map, waiting for us to trigger the animation scene where we start running and then it spawns in behind us. Many of my viewers out there will know I do love a good Easter egg, and one of them in The Evil Within is how we can see this chap stood at the window of the mansion during Chapter 9. Now, I don't believe there's any mention of who this guy is, but I think many do believe it could be a reference to Henry from Silent Hill 4, which would kind of make sense because he is stuck in a room, and he does look similar when we take a closer look at him. He's even got the shirt and the vest underneath. When we get closer with our character, he does walk away from the window, so let's take a look at where he goes. I wasn't going to include this in the video, but I just know if I don't, someone will ask for it. So for anybody wanting to know what's up the blocked off stairs on the second floor of the mansion, here it is. During Chapter 9 we have a dabble at brain surgery, but one of the heads interested me more than any other, and it was this one that is normally pretty difficult to see the face of using the normal camera due to its restrictions, but when I saw it, it kinda reminded me of someone. Spooky mansions often have spooky pictures or portraits on the walls to go with them, it's kinda hand in hand. But check this out, in various places outside the walls of the mansion, we can find hidden textures of the portraits that we see hanging up inside. And that's not all for strange pictures. If we fly the camera outside, there's also this boxed off area that has a weird arrangement of the same picture. I haven't yet figured out why this is here. You can see here just how far outside the map I found this, as that is the mansion in the background. Try to keep your eyes on Sebastian in this one, guys, and let's just take a quick zoom out just to show how big some of these maps are, even though the playing area we get to run around in is very small in comparison. At the end of chapter 10, Laura grabs us through the bars of the elevator, and strangely enough, by moving the camera, we can see she also gets pulled through the floor and comes down with us before disappearing. We're coming to the end now, but at this point, whilst crawling through these tunnels, we see Amalgam Alpha walk above us. The second time, he even tries to grab us through these bars. But for some reason, he then runs off down the car park before being sick. Very strange behaviour, but that is it for this one, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. Join me next time for part 3, and then we've got the Gore Fest video coming shortly after, where I'll be showing all the goriest parts of the game from views that you don't normally get to see. Until next time, as always, take care and stay slippy.